keep on calling.
510-848-5732. It's all up to you.
These are your listener-supported radio stations, KPFA, KPFB in Berkeley, and KFCF in Fresno, and online at kpfa.org. It's time for About Health with Dr. Michael Lenore. All right, good health, and welcome to today's edition of About Health. I'm your host, Dr. Mike Lenore. Glad to be back with you. Certainly glad to be back with you and an opportunity to bond with you and to work with you to help us support KPFA. And we're going to be talking about that throughout the program. I mean, one of the things that we always say here during this period of time and other periods of time is that we offer you the least expensive second opinion in town. And no matter how much you give to KPFA, if we save you an office visit, a thought, an anxiety, if we do any of those things as we bring you the people that we're talking to, are the people that that talk to you, or if I talk to you, then we want you to recognize that KPFA is one of the few places where this kind of thing can happen, and I'm glad to be able to take part in it on this particular Monday, and hope that you will stay with us until the latter part of the show when you can express your appreciation for KPFA by helping to keep us on the air. These are desperate times, and it's desperate measures that keep these kinds of radio stations going. I think if you recognize the kind of consolidation, amalgamation that's going on in health, that same thing is going on all over the country. So today we're going to take time to answer your questions. We'd expected a special guest, but that guest is not here, but I'm here and I'm glad to take that person's place. If you've got a question, a comment you want to ask about it, something that's happened to you or something that you want to know about, then the number is 510-848-4425 or 1-800-958-9008. So we'll be here for you if you have a question. So if we got something lingering from past programs, or if you suddenly developed a symptom, or if you had an experience, or you want to talk policy, then 848-4425, the 510 area code is what we're looking at. Well, a couple of good things happened today. You know, Donald Trump announced he was not running. That's a good thing, and I'm not surprised by that. But it's still a good thing. I don't care. I don't exactly know why I'm so elated he's not running, because I think him running will probably give me more satisfaction in the end than his running. But here's another thing that I'm not surprised about, and you shouldn't be either. Insurers take in record profits as U.S. residents spend less on health care. Isn't that interesting? It's incredible that for the third year in a row, largely because residents are postponing or foregoing care because of these high premiums and these high deductibles and the economic recession, then we're not spending the money that the insurance companies have laid out, the bare minimum money they've laid out to take care of us. Many experts say that patients have remained very conscious of any kind of spending during the economic downturn, which could lead them to be more selective about the kinds of things that they get. You know, and I think what's interesting about this is kind of a natural way in which the market works. As they keep ratcheting up these prices, then what's going to happen is consumers are going to take another look at some of the options that they have in health care. And so that if that happens, then they're going to take some of the less expensive options. And I think that there's nothing different about that. But here's what's going to happen. Eventually, and maybe this year, we're going to get to the tipping point where your options and the things that you want to do and you want to have done and need to have done get compromised in your desire to save money, because these deductibles, I've got patients that come to see me, deductibles are $3,000, $4,000. So I think under those circumstances, we really have to start to look at where it's going to be the tipping point where your need for good health care and involvement in good health care, that need outstrips your need to be frugal outstrips your need to have good health care. And I'm just amazed at what I'm seeing. What you're seeing in the healthcare industry right now is you're seeing a consolidation of all these big groups. Now, there are a lot of groups out there that are putting doctors together and hospitals together, and I think that's the future. I hate to say it because it makes me sad and nostalgic, but situations where, like me, where a doctor sits on the corner and provides you with that kind of personalized health care, I think I might be the last decade of that. So that under those circumstances, I think that we might be I don't want to say a dying breed. That's a little scary to me. But we might be a dinosaur in health because people are not going to be able to do that in the future. They have what they call these accountable care organizations that they're putting together. And what are these organizations? Well, these organizations are groups of doctors in hospitals, and they give them one pile of money to take care of everyone. So consequently, under those circumstances, what you're going to have is you're going to have if you're not in a group, then, you know, just kind of hanging out on the corner, being there for your patients, knowing who they are, knowing their children, and all that, that may be occur, but it's not going to occur in the environment that we're talking about right now. So I think that's something to worry about. And if you've got some ideas, or if you've had some experiences with your insurance, or even if you benefited, has anybody out there benefited from the new health care law? I want you to give us a call at 510-848-4425 or 1-800-958-9008 and tell us what your experiences have been in relationship to that. Another thing that's happening, it's allergy season. I think, you know, most of you know I am an allergist, and this season has been interesting. In many instances, what happens is that the rains determine and define the quality of the allergy season. That means the more rain you have early in the season, the more likely you are to have very big pollen seasons, where there's trees and grasses involved. And that's what most people tend to equate with the allergy season. That season runs from February generally through June. But if there is rain in between those times, it washes the pollen out of the air. And as the pollen comes out of the air, then that means that the season stops. Like today, it's going to rain a little bit. So those of you who've been really suffering the last couple of weeks will get a little bit of a break. And then if it warms up again, some of that pollen stays around. And some of these grasses stay around a little bit longer, so the season may last a little longer. So if you've got allergy or asthma, you want to talk about that, that's another topic. We're trying to throw these topics out because with the special guest we expected did not arrive. And I don't want you to be without any information, because I want to remind you of what we try to do here at KPFA every Monday from 2 to 3. And I want you to be involved in helping us to stay together as a team here at KPFA and to stay together on the air. Let me give you some things that you can do that you might not have considered if you have an allergy problem. First of all, using special filters in the heating and cooling system is really a good idea. You know, a lot of people do the dust thing. They put the pillow and the mattress covers on, and they may even get a HEPA filter or the right vacuum cleaner. But if you can put in some high-efficiency filtration systems in your heating system, that does more to take out particles than just about anything else, especially dust and mold and certain kind of insect parts that are in your house. So some of these high-efficiency media filters into the furnace or into the air conditioning system can be very, very helpful. Another thing is to check the vents. You know, pay close attention to directions in the household vents. The vents you use in the bathroom and when you're cooking to remove moisture, I think, is another thing you have to look at. Sometimes in your bedroom, if you've got an allergy, like a house dust allergy, you have to take and put something on the top of those vents so that you don't get so much cool air into the phone system. So that's another thing. And that you said, well, what's that got to do with pollen? Well, we know that this whole process is a cumulative process. That means you have house dust one day, and then you have that stacks on top of cat, which stacks on top of grass and tree and weed, so that if you can reduce any of those allergens and reduce any of that exposure, then you can certainly, you'll be much more comfortable. The other thing is start treatment early. That means earlier in the season. We're a little bit late for that, but start the treatment early. If you start early enough, you can reduce the kinds of symptoms that you have, the congestion, the sneezing, the other things. You can prime your nasal passages, A, by eliminating triggers, which we just talked about, but also by doing the kinds of things that would allow you to be comfortable medically. I mean, there's not much you can do to avoid the pollen in grasses and trees. So sometimes herbs will work, but sometimes traditional medicine, which have been tested, will also work. And I think that just to kind of fight through it, one of the most effective things, though, is that neti pot. Many of you remember that. In fact, they even got it in the drugstore where it looks just like a pot. And you can put some steam, you can rinse your nose out, you can wash your nose out with the nasal saline rinses. And for many people, that may be all they need to kind of get through a big season like this. Another thing is change clothes outside the bedroom. If you change clothes inside the bedroom, you're tracking all this pollen that's being brought into your bedroom and you're sleeping there all night long, then that's another issue. Then monitor moisture indoors. There's more allergens in the air when it's humid, so that if you can keep it a little drier inside, trying to draw a balance between what's comfortable and what's dry, you will have not as many allergens. And avoid cross reactions. About 35% of people with seasonal allergies also show sensitivity to foods and house dust and other things, and so you have to know what those are. So then I think those are six tips that we don't usually give. I mean, I do think that this is a big allergy season, so if you've got an allergy problem, we're looking for you to call us at 1-848-4425 or 1-800-958-9008 if you're concerned about the healthcare situation. In terms of the insurance companies, let us know. We've talked about that a lot. But we, you know, what happened to Japan? That's the thing I don't get. I just don't understand it. Did they fix the reactor? I mean, where are we? We used to get these daily reports, 3, 4, 5, 6 times a day about what was happening in the reactors. I don't think anything has been solved. What happened? What happened to the nuclear reactors? Why are we hearing anything about them? Did the problem go away? All of a sudden, other events have taken over for us, and we don't. What happened? I mean, are we safe? We were counting nuclear particles in this country. Did we stop that? It just goes to show you how the media drives the discussion in these kinds of situations. So you want to talk about, anybody knows anything about Japan and what's happening, why don't you give us a call, 848-4425 and 1-800-958-9008. Now let's talk to one of my very favorite people in the whole world, Joy Moore. What's up?
Hey, buddy. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I mean, I'm better. I hurt my knee really badly. I fell off my bike, and I've been laid up for 2 weeks.
You kidding me?
I'm not kidding you, but you know what? There's always a silver lining because it gave me the opportunity to sit around and listen to your show.
I'm deeply appreciative. You know, Joy, what I was convinced when I was riding a bike? I was convinced when I was riding a bike that there was 800,000 drivers out there trying to kill me deliberately.
Now,
so I had to give it up, and I fell only one or two times, but that was enough because it takes me a lot longer to heal than it's taking you. So,
I don't know about that, but I have to tell you, I've been riding a bike for 12 years, and this is only the second accident I've ever had. But I have to agree with you. You know, both accidents were very serious. I hit my head in Sacramento and had to have stitches, and this time my knee has been out. But you know what else, though?
What?
I have to be honest. There's always the universe gives you gifts that sometimes you don't recognize.
Sometimes they come cloaked in so many other things. It's hard to
recognize. I know. But what has happened is I've been able to sit down and slow down. I have to take my body, my health, and my youth. I have to stop taking it for granted, and I got to be more careful on the bike. Those are the lessons that I'm working on right now while I'm trying to mend my knee. But that's not what I called about. I called because, first of all, I'm so thankful that you're talking about the Japan thing.
What happened to all the nuclear particles we were counting every day?
Hey,
I mean, what happened?
Schwarzenegger and his driver's divorce is more important than all of the radiation being dumped into the ocean every single minute that we sit here. Nobody's talking about how the ocean is being polluted. All we hear about is how they can't make enough car parts, so we're not going to get our Priuses anymore.
Mm-hmm.
It has to do with weapons of mass distraction. And, you know, we're always talking about how people
versatile.
Care or don't care. They're distracted from what the real important things are.
Birth certificates and Donald Trump and,
exactly.
You know, it just pushed day to day. I mean, look, it's not like they declared victory over these nuclear plants.
No.
And all of a sudden, you don't hear I haven't seen one single report on
you
those
haven't.
Plants in the last 2 weeks.
No, and this is the sad thing. The United States is still continuing to push. The people who are making money off of these things are still continuing to push. And Barack Obama, fortunately, unfortunately, depending on how you think about it, he's still pushing to continue licensing these radiation plants. So the other good thing, though, about all of this is it heightens everybody's awareness. Even if we're not hearing about it, that in itself is a story. People need to check that you're not hearing about how much radiation or radioactive material is being dumped or let into the ocean, how many people are affected by this, not just in Japan, but especially in Japan. And why is it that? Because it's not in the United States. We don't have to worry about it.
But more than that, we were worried about it every day. And now all of a sudden now there's no more discussion of it.
We had the William and Kate marriage. That was so important. We had to have every detail of that.
I'm going to ask. I'm going to get an update from my.
You're going to get an update. I don't have an update for you, except to tell you it's very bad.
Right.
I'm sure it's very bad.
Right,
the other thing I was left of Let It Go. I wanted to know, how does Barack Obama's health reform package affect the access or ability for people to deal with asthma and bronchitis and some of the other issues that. Particularly people of color face.
Well, anytime you improve access, you're going to improve some care. I'm just not sure, quite frankly, because, it's just such a patchwork of different things. It started at different times. All I can say is I think we need health care reform. It begins the discussion on that. I think that getting that, he kind of jump-started the process.
We don't have health care reform now.
No.
You agree with that?
Well, I think we have a couple things that you can put your hands on. One is you can keep your kids on your insurance till they're 26. Second is they can't turn you down for pre-existing conditions. That's another one. So those at least are a couple of things that we can, work with. But you're right. We don't quite have health care reform. But, everything goes through the sieve of these politics.
And people need to remember that we don't have health care reform, and this man wants to be reelected again.
Well, here's the question. It's an interesting question. I think that it's an interesting question about being someone who is relatively progressive. Politics is not the art of the perfect. It's the art of the deal. If he set down everything we wanted him to have. It was the Blue Dog Democrats that wouldn't let him have it. In the first term, and it's
that.
The Republicans in the second, and it's people voting against their own interests. Now the question is, do you throw him out? He's done more in health care reform than anybody else. It's nowhere near health care reform.
But it gets
us over the hump so we can begin a serious discussion about what meaningful health care reform would look like. And I'm not sure everybody wants it to be perfectly pure, and I can understand why you wouldn't want them to compromise on political promises. But the process is not, it's not a dictatorship. And I think it was those Blue Dog Democrats in the first term.
Yeah.
When they had the House and the Senate.
There's no such thing. There's such an oxymoron, either you're a Democrat or not. But the other thing is, I remember now, I didn't expect much from any government in this country, even one that supposedly is headed by an African-American person or mixed person or whatever you want to call it. But what I did remember, and I'm holding on to now, is he did ask for the people to stand behind him and make a big stance on, don't just elect me. If I remember correctly, and maybe I'm making this up, but I'm being very romantic about it. Who knows? There was a call for us to get out into the street and, make a big thing out of things that are important to us, and we haven't done that.
No, the only people that got out there were these Tea Party people. They're
exactly.
The ones. That, so they set the agenda, but I think that agenda.
Yeah, half of them are fake,
That's
a virtual community. They're not real.
But I think that Tea Party meeting's about to be adjourned. All right, but thank you very much, Joy. We hope to hear from you next week.
All right, thanks for giving me your time. I appreciate you.
All right, let's go to San Francisco. Dr. Bill, you're on About Health.
Thank you. I'm someone who's had to deal with workers' comp. I was exposed to what I'd consider an extraordinary amount, but it was enough of paint and wall molding and adhesives to and new carpeting to make me chemically sensitive in a lot of ways. And what we need to be talking about is a healthcare system where people stay healthy, and that unhealthy things are minimized, because let's say your neighbor has kids, the neighbor gets sick, for whatever reason, whether at work or not. If they can't stay at work, what happens? The kids and the breadwinner, their stability is gone. They may have to move. They may lose their house. They may lose their apartment. And meanwhile, you know, we're spending so much money on destruction in this country. It's extraordinary. When I tried getting workers' comp, basically in this country, multiple chemical sensitivity isn't accepted as a condition, even though it's recognized by many in the profession. So what's happened is that over time I've had to fight. I had to fight for getting a quarter or none of what or half of what I needed. And it's an exhausting process. Meanwhile, skills that I could bring to the community, even with a disability, you know, it's just hard to do that.
Yeah,
it's hard to contribute in a positive way because, heck, you got to keep roof overhead and food on the table, and those things cost money. It cost, luckily, in San Francisco, there's a pretty good health care system in terms of community health network through the community clinics of the Department of Health. And they've helped keep me reasonably healthy. You know, that's with developing diabetes and things like that. We've got to stop letting corporate America dump the cost of health care, whether that's the insurance companies, whether that's the chemical companies, whether that's the petroleum companies, because, you know, they're skating on it. They're sending money to the Cayman Islands and everywhere else while we're suffering. I'm suffering. There are a lot of people doing a whole lot worse than me. They lose their families.
Right.
They lose their homes. They lose a lot more of their health than I have.
And most cities don't have a health care system like San Francisco. So you're right. That is a blessing in many ways.
You know.
But anyway, so thank you very much for that comment, Bill. I think you a lot of people share that same sentiment. And one of the things that we can do, though, is we can support radio stations like KPFA. Even if all we're doing is talking to one another, I think sometimes that plants a seed of activity and it reinforces some of the philosophies that people have and lets people know that there are other people out there who care about what's going on. So toward the end of the program, we're going to give you an opportunity to join and support KPFA. And we want you to stay with us and show us that that you care about open discussion. You care about open discussions about health. You care about the opportunity to share your opinions and get questions answered. And we're going to be working on that. Let's go next to Lorna in Pittsburgh. You're on About Health.
Hello, Dr. Lenore.
Hello, Lorna.
This is my first time calling in, so I just wanted to appreciate your program. You have to excuse my voice. I'm one of those with the allergies really bad right now.
Right.
And it's been just draining in my throat and down to my chest. And now it seems like I'm just hoarse. And when I call for a sneeze, it hurts was beginning to hurt in the chest. And I'm wondering if I've been recently taking or drinking ginger with apple cider vinegar and cloves.
Uh-huh.
And I'm just wondering if I should just continue that on and give it time kind of kick in, or if there's something else that I could do.
Yeah, I like a mix of traditional and non-traditional approaches to most problems in health, but certainly to the allergy problems. The difficulty here is that there's just so much in the air that your nose reacts to. It just swells up and swells shut, and it's a lot of sneezing and eye symptoms. And I sometimes think that either over-the-counter antihistamines or medicines by prescription to get you through this in 1 month is a good idea in conjunction with things like you're doing. So I think if you've got reached the point where you're really pretty miserable, and many people are, just for a couple of weeks, it never hurts. I mean, sometimes medicines are herbs that work. I think that traditional medicines can sometimes be as helpful. But over-the-counter medicines first, first of all, some of the things we talked about in terms of avoiding triggers first. And then, you know, anything that you think will work from the non-traditional approach. And then maybe over-the-counter medicines and then maybe traditional prescription medicines, all just to get you through this month. There's so much pollen in the air out there. It's difficult to avoid. And I don't think I've seen this much pollen in the air when it is in the air in almost 25 years. So you might try some of those steps if you feel that you're not getting the kind of outcomes that you really want.
Okay.
But thanks for calling. Stay around, Lorna. We're going to ask you to join KPFA in just a few minutes, so don't leave
us. I am a member, but I need to renew.
All right. All right, let's go now to Fresno. Talk to Bart. You're on About Health.
Good morning, or good afternoon. I just had a question. The other day, my wife and I were at a friend's house, and as we were leaving, we noticed they had a kumquat tree. So we went over, and he said, help yourself. So we, you know, started gorging on these kumquats as they were driving away. And within about 10 minutes, my wife began to break out mid-torso with some fiercely itching red spots. And they're still with her today. And we're just wondering, is it possible that a person could have, like, an allergy to high levels of citrus that could break her out like that?
Usually it's to a particular element of the kumquat itself. So, I mean, I have several patients who can't take kumquats, and there's some other fruits in that family. Does she ever have any other allergy reactions to any other foods?
Well, you know, as we think about it, she's had similar outbreaks in the past. We never associated it with anything in particular, but it was just so immediate, you know, and so I didn't realize that, and we have eaten kumquats before, but I think we're just kind of like just so pleased that we found this trove of kumquats that we just kind of like hogged them, you know.
Yeah, well, you know, they kumquats, you know, generally what happens is that people, allergies are a manifestation of two things. One is the amount, and the other is the exposure. And so a lot of people don't get kumquats, you know, because it's not like I see them all the time, like in Safeway or places like that. But it's certainly possible that you can have them once and then eat more of them. And then once you eat them again, you start to have a reaction. That's pretty traditionally what happens in allergies, especially in those allergies in adults. It's more likely to have a problem with seafood or nuts, but certainly seafood as adults get older. I know you know many people who used to be able to eat seafood but now can't do it. So I think she had an allergic reaction. I think you're fortunate it wasn't any more significant than just a few breakouts, and that's what's likely to happen again. But I do think that what she should do anytime she has a similar reaction in the future, write down everything you eat and see if you can develop some commonalities in terms of what's causing the problem. All right.
Okay, just one more question.
Sure.
If these spots persist, is there any topical treatment or anything that you might recommend?
No, usually antihistamines like Benadryl or what I recommend is Zyrtec during the day because it doesn't cause any drowsiness, and Benadryl or something like that at night for a few days, and then usually they disappear.
So you're saying that perhaps she may be subject to an anaphylaxis or something?
No. I think what she had was an anaphylactic-like reaction. I mean, anaphylaxis can go on to develop gastrointestinal problems and lung problems and central nervous system problems, but usually the first one is a dermatologic problem. So she just developed a rash, which is usually hives, and it's usually self-limiting. You can make it more comfortable with antihistamines. You should be careful of kumquats or other things that are in that family of fruits, and you should always write down when you have a new reaction in the future what you had to see if you can make some relationships.
So are kumquats known to create these types of reactions?
Well,
more than any other type of citrus?
No, not really.
Oh, okay.
Not really. I mean, it's unusual, but so is eating kumquats unusual. All right.
So thank you.
Take care. 848-4425-51 area codes. We want you to stay around because this is our time to support and help KPFA. We want you to be in that number. I think that's said in a biblical expression or a song or something, but we want you as part of our KPFA family. 848-4425 or 1-800-958-9008. If you want to start pledging now, here's where you can call, 848-5732, 848-5732, and call and pledge and renew your membership and get a new membership. Less than 1 out of 10 people listen to KPFA, get that membership. Remember, even a kumquat question saves you a trip to the doctor and some future date, and so use that money to pledge the KPFA. All right, let's go now to Arnold in San Francisco. You're on About Health.
Yeah, how you doing? I'm a KPFA listener. I learned a lot on KPFA, including, you know, you've been saying some things, political things on this medical show that I just have to respond to. I, I got this information from Martin Luther King's doctor that's on the morning show. And him and Michael Moore, too, is saying that, eliminating preconditions, that's only like $100 a day for the insurance companies, the penalties. It's so light that it practically doesn't matter.
No, I'm not sorry. You mean
it's $100 a day, and that's not going to prevent insurance companies from keeping people from pre-existing conditions. And also, that 26 to extending it to 26-year-olds and insurance, that could have been passed by separate legislation.
Okay, so
you know, you got a president who gave 200 amendments. Let the Republicans attack, and he didn't get a single Republican vote. He let Joe Lieberman determine the limits of the debate. Again, he worked against public options. He let Joe Lieberman say that we shouldn't have a public option. And then he worked to get the public option out. And in fact, his chief of staff, Rahm Emanuel, who's the mayor of Chicago now, when he was Obama's chief of staff, he called those of us that are working for a public option a bunch of effing retards. You know, I can't let what you're saying stand. You know, if you want people to contribute, you better do your homework. You better listen to KPFA, because it sounds like you're listening to NPR, sir.
Well, I think...
If you want me to give you some money, you better start talking the truth.
Wait. Let's have a rational discussion about this. I wasn't responding. I wasn't saying whether or not I thought he was perfect. I'm saying that we have a start on the healthcare conversation. It's not a perfect plan. No plan is perfect. There are lots of reasons why it didn't pass. A lot of reasons why it didn't pass. And I think that when you have the perfect truth, and you have a way in which we can get this done, give us the roadmap by which we can get into the situation of decision makers who can give us what we want. We can't even get single payer in California through the California legislature. So you give us the perfect path. It doesn't do any good to sit down and scream and holler about what ought to be done. We need to have somebody who can do something. Now, if you think you've got a way and a mechanism by which you should never lose your principles, and I'm not saying that, but whenever you figure you have out a way in which this point of view gets some traction politically, then I'm certain there'll be a lot of people standing in line to follow exactly what you say. But just screaming and hollering at the present system without a roadmap to get us to where we think we need to be, I think it's probably not the most effective way to do it. But hey, that's why you have principles. All right, let's go next to Barbara in Yorkville. You're on About Health. Barbara? Hello? Barbara?
Yes.
You're on About Health.
Oh, hi. Yeah, I'm just two parts to my question.
Sure.
I'm wondering how much... in general, genetically engineered organisms may have to do with allergies and the increasing incidence of allergies and asthma among the population. That's one part. And the other one is the more specific about the guy who ate the kumquats and his wife. Did they know whether or not the tree had been sprayed with pesticides or chemical fertilizers before they went eating things right off the tree? And if so, I mean, could that be possible? A reason for the rash?
Yeah, I think yes and yes. I think we don't really know what the effect of these genetically engineered fruits and vegetables are going to be because they haven't been had enough exposure. They talk about them being safe to eat, but in terms of how they've been altered and how the body responds to them, I don't think we really know that. So I think that's the first thing. We really don't know that. And I think your second part of your question was about the fruit being sprayed.
Yeah, did they wash them?
I don't know that either.
Yeah.
Because I think some of these pesticides can give you the same kinds of rashes that you get when you have an allergy problem. So I think from both of those perspectives, I think that you're right. Those are very good points.
Okay, thank you.
All right, let's go now to James in San Leandro. You're on About Health.
Yes. I'm coming back to the issue of chemical sensitivities.
Uh-huh.
There doesn't seem to be enough dialogue going on that. I'm chemically sensitive. I have friends who are chemically sensitive. I cannot go into a nail shop. I can't pick up my wife in a nail shop. I have to stay out of acrylics. I have to actually keep myself completely isolated from things like that. And this is not something that just started in my life. It's been going on for many years. I have actually had to get off of BART trains when people have real strong perfumes and colognes on. I've done some reading about this, but there doesn't seem to be a great deal of dialogue about this. Is there anything that you can add to what is this? What should I be doing about it? I was told some years ago to keep essential oil with me. Doctor, it works for me.
Yeah.
When I find myself exposed to perfume or any kind of, in fact, cheap perfumes and colognes, what does it? I just like to know more about where it may lead, or if you've done any research, or is there any articles that you can recommend that I read?
You know, there are lots of very good articles on multi-chemical sensitivity because it's been around for such a long period of time. I mean, actually, when I first went into practice, there was more enthusiastic about it because people were doing research to try and decide and define what caused it.
Mm-hmm.
There are lots of people who cannot be around chemicals.
Mm-hmm.
The problem is, and here's what makes it difficult in our healthcare system, if you can't prove that a particular chemical causes a particular outcome,
mm-hmm.
then they can marginalize it.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I know as an allergist, there really aren't any major ways to test for chemical sensitivity. There just isn't. I mean, if you try to do the classic skin test or blood test, you just don't get down to the right chemical portion,
uh-huh.
or they're so irritating that they all read positive.
Mm-hmm.
So when that happens, then it becomes a discussion.
Mm-hmm.
They've looked at it for a number of reasons. At one point, it was thought to be the Epstein-Barr virus.
Mm-hmm.
It was one of the things. Yeast was talked about.
Mm-hmm.
But now we know it's not probably not those things, but we do know as clinicians that it does exist. There's no question about it. And there are people who have it as a problem.
Mm-hmm.
And here's the other big problem with it, James, is that the only treatment for it is to avoid the areas where you have chemical sensitivity.
Wow.
Now, if people live in, living just around, that means you'd have to move to some isolated place where there are very few other people.
Mm.
And so that we don't have good treatments for it, we can only treat the symptoms. But the fact that it does exist is pretty well known. There's a very good discussion on it. There's a very good discussion of it on in Wikipedia, actually. I mean, they have a very good discussion of the whole problem.
Okay.
And the research that went along with that particular problem. So
okay.
I think you got it, and you know you've got it. And from listening to you, I believe you have it, but trying to prove it and trying to define those chemicals and then to take some meaningful action with the environments in which you have to come in contact is very, very difficult. So we end up simply just treating symptoms.
One other thing about that, I know that I have a sensitivity to petroleum distillate.
Right.
In fact, to the point where when I fill up my tank, I have to leave the cock on the nozzle open,
uh-huh.
walk away by at least 15 feet.
Yeah, yeah. Well, you definitely got all the symptoms, but the question is, I mean, what can be done? I think the future is brighter because they do a lot more things in Europe to make the diagnosis and to try to manage it. But in this country, it just becomes an inconvenience for the system, and so consequently, there are not very many good answers to the problems that you have when you have this particular issue. All right. Well, thanks for taking the time to call us, James. We appreciate it. All right, we have another James. You're on About Health. Hello?
Hello?
Hello? James in Fresno?
Yes. Mike.
Yeah.
How are you?
I'm good.
I was hearing you at the beginning of your show, and you were talking about the insurance companies.
Right.
And we have an opportunity in this state with SB 810, which passed the state Senate Health Committee recently, to do way better than what was able to be done at the federal level. And so KPFA listeners should be active on this.
Is this the same bill that was up last year?
It's very similar. SB 840, then Sheila Kuehl was the sponsor for that, actually passed twice and was vetoed twice by Governor Schwarzenegger. SB 810, now that Sheila Kuehl was termed out, is sponsored by Mark Leno. And as I said, it recently passed the State Senate Health Committee. It will need to go to the whole State Senate and then to the Assembly. So we're probably looking at a two-year process on this. But if
what does that bill
what benefit do we
yeah,
get?
Yeah, what
do
we get? What are the benefits
for companies? The insurance companies add no value. They just take money out of the system, a lot of money. And this will allow healthcare to be doctors and patients with a what they call a single payer system. You can also think of it as a single risk pool system. That is, the insurance companies right now don't compete on the basis of quality. They compete on figuring out who can select the healthiest risk pool so that they collect the insurance but don't have to pay out for the services. And this will get rid of them and return health care to doctors and patients.
Is it similar to the Massachusetts plan?
No. Massachusetts plan is similar to what they got at the federal level. No, this is similar to Canada.
Okay, well, yeah.
Except with more money.
Yeah, we always thought it was going to pass last year and the year before last, and did pass, actually.
Yeah.
And then the governor, and what is Jerry Brown state anything, position on it?
Well, I think if we push him hard enough, we'll get it.
All right. Well, thanks for Queens. I knew that we in California had several opportunities, and we're very close to passing some kind of a health single payer system. And so I think we can be hopefully optimistic.
Oh, Dr. Lenore,
yeah.
We'd love to continue taking more calls, but I think it's time for us to try and raise some money to support this station. So we do have a couple of callers on the line, but maybe if we can get 10 people to call in and pledge until the end of the hour, we can take the other calls that are coming in. So I want to give out the number that people can call. It's 510-848-5732 or 1-800-439-5732. And why don't you tell us a little bit about the special thank you gift that people can get if they pledge $100. But we'll take any pledge level.
Well, I get a membership to KPFA, which is worth much more than $100. Turns out to be less than 50 cents a day or 75 cents a day. And they get Smart Medicine for Healthier Living by Janet Land, Dr. Alan Spreen, and Dr. James Lavelle. This is a book that gives you a number of, talks about a number of conditions. Almost every condition is discussed and ways in which you can take care of those conditions. It's $100. And so consequently, I think this is a pretty good deal for that and KPFA. But if you don't have the $100, and you know, or if you don't feel that you want some value for that, then just pledge membership to KPFA by calling 510-848-5732 or 1-800-439-5732. Remember, this is a very tough time for anybody who is doing this kind of work. I mean, if you think about KPFA, even though you may not agree with us at a certain point or not, you do get a chance to discuss issues and hear about issues in ways that are not generally traditional. No other radio station in this area allows you to call on a weekly basis and talk to experts in particular fields or express your opinions or try to get advocacy positions out or even talk about events. So that if we can just do a bit to support that station, then I think that we can do a bit more to step it up from our end and bring you even more interesting people and a little bit more variety in our programming for next year. But this is the way we call the cheapest second opinion in town. Many times you'd have to pay much larger sums just to get less meaningful answers. And so we think if you could just call and support us, the number 848-5732 or 1-800-439-5732, the DVD, Smart Medicine for Healthier Living, Dr. Janet Land, Dr. Alan Spreen, Dr. James Lavelle.
Okay, I do want to mention that it's not a DVD. It is a book, and it has so many bits of information, as Dr. Lenore has mentioned. And I, again, will repeat those numbers. It's 510-848-5732 or 1-800-439-5732. Just think of the many experts that About Health has brought on. We've had Dr. Giacomo, talking about foot problems. We've had Dr. Jim Otis telling you about alternative ways to produce health. We've had on so many wonderful people. And as Dr. Lenore said, this is where you can call and get an opinion, a very valuable opinion. And all you have to do is pick up the phone. You don't have to pay. So now to keep this program and other programming going at KPFA, please call 510-848-5732 or 1-800-439-5732. And also joining me here is Josh Elwood. Josh, what do you think about that?
That's right. You know, this is an I grew up at KPFA. This is an institution. The stuff that Dr. Lenore does is very important to KPFA. The work he puts in, the work Mickey puts in. The number is 848-5732, 1-800-439-5732.
This book, Smart Medicine for Healthier Living, written by Dr. Janice Land. Dr. Land has had over 20 years of experience in natural medicine, is the co-founder and formulator of the Zan Herbal Formula. She's nationally respected. Dr. Alan Spreen is from the East Tennessee State University Medical School and established himself as a special nutritional therapist in Jacksonville. He's founded the Nutrition Physician, and Dr. James Lavelle has been involved with natural medicine for the past 15 years. The book is divided into three parts. Part one explains the full spectrum of approaches used to treat common health problems. It provides history, fundamentals, and a variety of different ways to approach it. And then in the second part of the book, you tell it, each entry in that section explains the problem, specific advice on a variety of approaches, and then the part three is step-by-step guidance on using the many therapies and procedures suggested in part two. Now, we're not always successful here in merging both traditional and non-traditional health, but we try. And I think you need to hear both sides of the equation. You need to know what your options are, and I think for many programs, they talk primarily about the traditional approaches, and I think many of them are fine, without question. But in terms of trying to integrate the ideas of integrated medicine, I think you'll find that nobody does it better than we do it, and nobody does it as often as we do it from the physician perspective. We've got other health shows on KPFA, which are equally as good, and I think the only way we can continue this is we know, and you know, that this is a difficult time. So if you will simply call 510-848-5732 or 1-800-439-5732. I would appreciate it. For $100, you get Smart Medicine for Healthier Living. But if you don't have the $100, please just pledge at KPFA.
Right. We would so appreciate your pledge. You can pledge $25 and join at the basic membership level. That gives you a chance to be a voting member of KPFA. There are no callers on the line right now, Dr. Laura.
Yes.
Come on. We know there's plenty of listeners out there because folks have been calling in with questions. So if some of you listeners could pick up the phone and call 510-848-5732.
You know, it's embarrassing, but I'm not disappointed. Because that just means that next year we're going to have to do an even better job of bringing more interesting people. But we do think that we should be able to, you know, many times they preempt our ability to pledge. But I told Mickey, there are enough people out there who care about our program that we should be able to raise money for our station. And that you should appreciate the kinds of things that we're trying to do as we appreciate how you make our program so good by calling in and sharing your stories with us, sharing your ideas with us, giving us advice, sometimes yelling at us a little bit. We appreciate that. Makes for good radio programs. That gives you an opportunity. And we would be just hopeful that someone would call and say thank you, not to me, because I enjoy doing this. This is what I do. But to the station that allows me. I've worked at other major radio stations, big ones, and they would never allow you to do the kinds of things that we're doing here. So you have to help us. Man, you have to help us find our place here, the KPFA family, by pledging something. If you want $100, if you want to pledge $100, you get Smart Medicine for Healthier Living, the book. But otherwise, you can pledge just for memberships.
And there are many other thank you gifts if you're not interested in this particular book. There are many other thank you gifts. But again, I'm not seeing that there are any calls on the line, and I'm sure that there are some folks out there who'd be willing to support us, even at the basic membership level. So please, please be that first caller to show your appreciation for About Health. Please call 510-848-5732 or 1-800-439-5732. Please let us know that you appreciate the free speech that About Health brings you. Not only can you check in with Dr. Lenore and our experts about health issues, but you can check in with him about many other issues that impact the world. and it's only here at KPFA that you can do that. So please show your support.
I just knew that there'd be a lot of people calling us here at 1-800-459-5732 or 848-5732. Maybe you just haven't ever called and you think the pledge process is difficult, but it's not. But we need to have the support that only you can give us here at KPFA in order for us to keep the kind of programming on the air that we have. Getting these experts out is not easy. Many of them have other options, but many of them enjoy the discussions that we have here with the audience, and so they are very happy to come. But if you think about how much you spend just getting the bus or the cab or the gas now to get to a medical office to have them answer the same questions that you ask without any fanfare, without any prejudice, then that's worth $100 a visit, $150 a visit. So we need for you to get on the phone, 1-800-459-5732 or 510-848-5732.
Yes, I do have, we do have two callers on the line, and I'd like to send a shout out to Joy Moore, who is pledged, and also Doris Dritzaff. Thank you so much. If we could just get a couple more callers on the line. We do have some callers who are calling in for some health feedback. If we can get a couple more people on the line to pledge their support, then we can go back to the callers who are calling in to get Dr. Lenore's expertise and sage wisdom. So again, the numbers to call are 510-848-5732. Or 1-800-439-5732.
This book, Smart Medicine for Healthier Living, gives you all the opportunities. It's hard to wade sometimes through the jungle of health. I mean, the jungle of health full of notions and misconceptions and ideas and prejudices and expenses. And we try to help you navigate that whole path. So we need your help. We need the opportunity to stay here. I don't want to give up my spot to someone else because they're more popular, that their audience is more appreciative, or that their audience is more engaged or more active. We want you to call us at 510. Give us the number, Mechanic.
It's 510.
I got so excited. Lost my place.
Oh well, there's another caller on the line. If we can get a couple more callers, we can go back to one of our listener call-ins. The number is 510-848-5732 or 1-800-439-5732. Let me say them once more, and I've been told we should say this slowly because people may want a chance to write down the number. So it's 510-848-5732 or toll-free 1-800-439-5732 because we do get calls when Dr. Lenore is taking callers from listeners from Fresno, from Saratoga, from Los Angeles. We get calls from all over the state of California. So you listeners out there, here's a chance to call and show your support by calling 1-800-439-5732 or 510-848-5732. A couple more callers on the line, and we can go back to taking a call about the health issues of the day.
Yeah, Bill, when you think about it, I hear again, I mean, we're in an economic downturn, I got to go to the economics. We are trying to bring in people that will save you money. You have the opportunity. Many of our best guests have been suggested by the audience. We read a book or see a paper. We do have enough juice to get these people to come and talk to you on a radio program. We get calls all the time by people, and we do a lot of screening for you. I mean, we take people who are in traditional medicine who are just trying to utilize the system and take advantage of people. We see people in non-traditional medicine who don't have proven methods. We don't put them on the air. We don't screen. But if you suggest them, even if we may not agree, we generally try to get them to you. So if you want us to continue to do this, and you don't want me to walk out of this station today feeling just down because we didn't have the kind of responses that we wanted.
No, we don't want that.
It's not personal. I will recover. I don't want you to get scared. I will recover. But I do want you to understand how important it is, how much time it takes for Mickey to prepare this program, for us to get the people down here, for us to even get them to come to KPFA, although they do love the audience when they get there. So please call us at 510-848-5732 or 1-800-439-5732. If you want to pledge $100, you can go to Smart Medicine for Healthier Living, Janet Land, Dr. Alan Spreen, Dr. James Lavelle, all MDs, all known as people interested in the integration of traditional and non-traditional health.
Okay, Dr. Lenore, we do have one guest. Maybe we can take that one guest and we'll trust people to call and support us. We're at 510-848-5732 or 1-800-439-5732. Come on, folks. Let's show Dr. Lenore that we love him and
show him some love
that we support this. You know, he takes time off from his practice to come down and talk to you guys. He brings in experts who take off time from their practice to give you feedback, to give you information. Please show us some support at 510-848-5732 or 1-800-439-5732. And do you want to take that call from Frank in Kensington?
All right, Frank, you're on About Health.
Hey, Dr. Lenore.
Yeah.
The reason why I called, well, there's two reasons, but the second one just came up. But the main one is to let you know of what's happening with the Japanese reactor situation.
Oh, thank you, man. I mean, you're my only source, the only contact.
Yeah.
What's happening over there?
Most of what I've been picking up has been on KPFA, interesting enough. And if people want to, you know, find out what's going on, they better pledge. But anyway, Dr. Carl Grossman was on last week, and there have been a couple of other things. Basically, toward the end of last week, I think Thursday, they had a chance to look inside the main reactor there in Fukushima and discovered that there's a big hole in the bottom, and it's Chernobyl all over again, maybe worse.
Oh, wow.
They're talking the China syndrome stuff. The water, they pumped in enough water to try and cool those fuel rods to fill the entire vessel. And it's the level of the water hasn't come up. So now they know it's going out the bottom. There's a big hole in the bottom.
Oh, you're kidding me.
And the melted fuel rods are heading down. And I guess ultimately what could happen is it could hit the water table and then there'll be a huge explosion.
Oh, you're kidding me. What about the workers that have been working there?
They're saying they need another 3,000 because those initial 1,000 have been exposed too much to allow them to be exposed anymore. In fact, they probably have... really volunteered for the
role. And why do you think this disappeared so quick? I mean, I'm just stunned by how quickly we were. One day we were following minute to minute, then the Libyan war broke out, and then, you know, and we haven't heard anything about it since.
I think they're looking for stories to cover this up. I think they're panicked that the, you have to remember there's about 400 reactors in the world, and GE, Westinghouse, Babcock and Wilcox, the main companies that make these things. Toshiba is one of them. They own Westinghouse now. Well, they're also owners of the media in the United States. This is really bad for the business.
Well, I'm just absolutely stunned. But thank you for taking the time to join us and tell us.
Yeah,
and give
the
us
other thing I was going to say was that I wanted to tell everybody out in the listening audience that I personally believe that you saved my wife's life.
Oh, really?
And I want everyone to call in and support you, because this is really important. We need you on the air.
Well, I appreciate you saying that, sir, and sometimes I'd like to know exactly what happened, but thank you for sharing.
Sure.
All right, I think that's all the time we have. Joy Moore will be with us, I think, next week. What's she going to do? All right, go ahead, Joy. Go ahead, Joy.
I'm going to ask people to call 510-848-5732 and contribute to KPFF and support the work that Dr. Lenore does. Dr. Lenore comes in week after week, year after year. It doesn't cost the KPFA anything. He gives up his time. He gives up his skill, his expertise, his connections. He loves the radio station. If you, anybody out there, loves the work that he does, cares about Dr. Lenore and the work he does, cares about KPFA and the wonderful thing that's going on here, call us right now, 1-800-439-5732 or 510-848-5732. I contribute. I love this show. And I know there are lots of people out there. Give what you can, $5, $10. Put it on the Discover card, your credit card, your debit card. EBT, there's so many ways. You send a check when you have it. There's so many ways to support the station. Don't let this opportunity go by. Please go to your phone. Call us right now and show you care about the show. Thank you, Dr. Lenore.
All right, and then let me just close the show by thanking the audience, because really, we've had some very good response to the show, but most of it is because you have been good about calling in and sharing your stories and staying with us and giving us advice and, you know, giving us policy issues, updates, and I think that makes the show. But one more time, the number 848 848-5732 and the 510 area code 1-800-439-5732. All right. Well, thanks to Mickey, and thanks to Joy, and thanks to the Anthony College Institute and the Bit Summit Medical Center. But most of all, thank you again for joining us and pledging on KPFA. Remember, health is your biggest asset. I'm Dr. Mike Lenore. We'll talk again soon.